actually started as two pieces. And back when I was writing them, I was working paratransit, and I would see people and just sort of imagine what their lives were like either before they had to use paratransit, or maybe their loved ones, how they interact with these people. And the first story was a man who saw a wasp on the bus I was driving, and he had what I would consider an irrational response to it. He was very agitated. And he told me a story of when he was really young and he was stung quite a bit and had to be buried in mud because they were in a remote location. And the second part of the story was watching a woman get a very tall man, probably about 6 feet, 6 inches tall, into a ridiculously small car. And I was just imagining, why is she taking him in that particular car? And where are they going? Because I knew the man. He couldn't talk, he could blink, that was about it. So I started to write her story, just my imagining of it. And neither one of those stories had an ending. And then one night, just can't sleep, and the ending that they could each end each other. So I combined the two of them, changed the gender of the characters in one of the stories, and voila.
We were just told that we were the pair, yeah, and yeah. I was given a copy of the story, and you know, we chatted for a bit, and we're kind of like, oh, we get along well, so this is great. And so yeah, I took the story home with me, and then read it a bunch of times to, you know, see what I wanted to pull from it. And after reading it, like, it's a very descriptive story, and I got a very good sense of like the characters and what they were doing, and so I didn't want to just sort of like replicate that in my work. So it was a bit of a challenge, just because I was like, oh, like here's this very, you know, these very real people, and I don't just want to sort of illustrate them because it feels kind of like a shadow of. So it's kind of like, what do I want to bring to the story, or what's something else? What's another way I can give people an entry point into this story and that sort of thing? And I was very interested in, you know, I think when we initially talked about the two parallel stories, or talking about how there were two stories without an ending, and reading it, that's really what came to mind, were these echoes like of what happened in one story and the other, because they end kind of by meeting at that point, and then that meeting point also echoes like an older story as well. So you kind of have all these things coming together. And so then that's what sparked me to think about, well, I want to draw attention to the fact that these are stories coming together. I put in sort of, there's the river that's the one path and the road that's the other path. So the idea of the river path and the road path meeting in the middle. And in the central panel, there's the bridge, and that kind of links the two, because that's where ostensibly the two stories meet up.
I do have a bit of a design background, and the first thing I said is, this is Heather's project and I don't want to be involved in it in any way other than here's my story. I think that once you publish something as a writer, it's no longer yours to decipher. People bring their own expectations, their own moral background, their own delusions to the story, and that's what they get out of it. When she first handed me the book, the first thing I thought of when I opened up was like an accordion map from, I love maps as a child, and I mean, as convenient as it is to have Google Maps on your phone, there's nothing like unfolding a paper map and having suddenly 18 square feet of paper in front of you. It was great to be part of. It's amazing watching somebody take your work and interpret it and come up with an object. I mean, that's an unbelievable feeling.